I want to be a boy again when I felt secure and taken care of, and all I had to worry about was doing what I was told, trying my best at school, and trying not to break anything. I want to be a boy again when I spent hours playing outside. I would pretend I was a cowboy or a soldier or just about anything I wanted to be. I wanted to ride my sled down the back alley that sloped enough to get you going so fast that you actually worried about a car coming at you at the very end. I want to be a boy again when I was dropped off at the Saturday matinee and there was a Duncan yo-yo contest on stage before the movie. Sometimes the winner got a twin bike, which was a pretty big deal. Then we watched Looney Tune cartoons and a feature film like A Space Adventure with Flash Gordon. And then we had to wait a whole week to find out if Flash ever escaped from the Martians. I want to be a boy again when TV was a wonder, and only a few families on the block actually had one. The hour before dinner, they showed Howdy Doody, and Clarabelle the Clown always soaked somebody with a seltzer bottle. And after that was Stagecoach Theater, and you hoped that dinner wasn't early, or else you'd never find out if the robbers got caught. And what about the rancher who had his cattle stolen and rebranded so he couldn't prove they were his? But then you knew Hopalong Cassidy would figure it all out and the bad guys would be hauled off to jail. I want to be a boy again when things weren't already built up, but being built. It was then that we would get our wagon out of the garage and go up and down the blocks above us where the new homes were being built. All the workers had gone for the day, so we could roam through the wood-framed rooms by ourselves and look for empty soda bottles. Each one was worth 2 cents. If we were lucky, we found a quart bottle. That one was good for a nickel. Then we'd take all the bottles in the wagon to the Acme supermarket down the corner and rake in our haul. Then we'd spend it all on candy before we left the store. I want to be a boy again when I came down the stairs on my birthday and there was always something colossal, like a new bike or a trip to New York. One year, among the presents was a white shirt with the airline's logos on it. Every airline logo was there on the shirt. I wanted to be an airline pilot, so this shirt was special. It was the first article of clothing I ever gave a hoot about, and when I wore it, I was an airline pilot. I want to be a boy again and go to summer camp and ride a horse, sail a boat, learn to swim. On Friday night, we'd watch a movie while sitting on a blanket in a grassy area and have a Hershey bar with almonds. We watched an old movie projected on a stretched-out bed sheet. When the movie was over, we marched back to our cabin in the dark, but we had flashlights to light the path. I want to be a boy again and look at the pictures in Life magazine when it arrived each week. I also watched the mail slot in the front door for whatever prize I got for sending in box tops from the cereal boxes. At Christmas time, there were a half dozen toy catalogs that came in the mail, and you'd spend hours going through them, circling the toys you wanted. Then every August, Popular Science magazine came, and it would have the coolest new cars on the cover, the ones that had all the new technology. The mail came in the morning back then, and during Christmas it came twice a day just to keep up with all the greeting cards that people sent to each other. I want to be a boy again when we always did something on the weekends as a family, whether it was a road trip to some farmer's market or a shopping mall at the new and only enclosed mall where every fall we got new clothes for school, or we'd go to a museum where I was bored, or to the zoo where I wasn't. And I want to be a boy again so I can be with my parents once more, in their prime when I thought they were the smartest people on earth. Just about everything they did was for the benefit of my brother and me, although we had no idea at the time. They made sure we got the basics and more. And when we didn't appreciate it, well, they taught us. They taught us about guilt and they taught us about discipline. We learned to balance the two. I remember rare occasions being spanked when I really did something major, like dropping the F-bomb when I was 11. I had no idea what the word meant, but the older boys playing basketball in the schoolyard said it a lot, and I thought it was cool, but not when I said it only once to my dad. But mostly, I want to be a boy again so I can tell my parents how much I love them, how much I miss them, and just once can we have dinner together again. I want to be a boy again so I have no responsibilities except to follow a few rules, share, and don't hit anybody. It was those times when I didn't have to worry about money or worry about my children or my wife and a bunch of other grown-up stuff. It was time when peace of mind was more present than it would ever be for the rest of my life, and I had no idea at the time how cherished that was. I want to be a boy again, so in a few years, I can fall in love with my wife, Rosemary, all over again. Young love is a stage of life like no other, and it consumes your whole being, and your emotions will be at a level of sensitivity never to be experienced again. I want to be a boy again, but life was simple. Life was easy. Life was happy. And thoughts of it being over were somewhere else, far, far off in the future. I'm Mark Kuhn. Thanks for listening.